Let's talk about another problem in relative velocity. Over here, the question says, on a long horizontally moving belt, a child runs to and fro with a speed of 9 km per hour with respect to the belt between his father and the mother located 50 meters apart on the moving belt. So question is quite clear. There's a conveyor belt on which the parents are standing, mother and father. The child runs between them with a speed 9 km per hour with respect to the belt. The belt moves with a speed of 4 km per hour itself, so the belt is also moving. For an observer on a stationary platform outside, what is the speed of the child running in the direction of motion of the belt? Speed of child running opposite to the direction of motion of belt? Time taken by the child in first two problems. These things can be solved using the concepts of relative velocity. Which answers alter if motion is viewed by one of the parents? So we have to see that if we stop observing as a stationary ground observer and we observe the child as parent standing on the belt, what quantities that we calculated in the above problem will change. So let's begin solving the problem from the first part. Now here you can see that the belt goes in this direction with a velocity 4 km per hour. The child runs with respect to belt at a velocity 9 km per hour. The first part says in the direction of belt. We're supposed to find what velocity the ground observer perceives. So if I write the equation of relative velocity, I can say that velocity of child with respect to belt is simply velocity of child minus velocity of belt. Both these velocities are with respect to ground. Now velocity of child with respect to belt is simply given as plus 9 because the sign convention we choose is right side positive and left side negative. So sticking with that, velocity of child with respect to ground is unknown. And the velocity of belt with respect to ground is 4. So if I basically solve this equation, I obtain velocity of child is plus 13 kilometers per hour. So ground observer observes the child to be actually running at 13 kilometers per hour in the right side direction. Now for the second part of the question, the child is running opposite to the direction of belt. So our belt goes in this direction, plus 4. Child moves in this direction, minus 9 kilometers per hour. So once again, if I write the equation of relative velocity, I'll see velocity of child with respect to belt is velocity of child minus velocity of belt. These two velocities are with respect to ground. Now the velocity of child with respect to belt is minus 9 because he's running in the opposite direction now. Velocity of child is unknown and velocity of belt is still plus 4. So if I solve this equation, I simply obtain velocity of child with respect to ground as minus 5 kilometers per hour. So what the ground observer will observe is that the child is running to the left direction or to the left side with a velocity of 5 kilometers per hour. Now let's talk about the third part of the problem in which we are supposed to calculate the time taken by the child in both the cases. So in the first case, when the child was running in the direction of the belt, what we observe as a ground observer that the mother appeared to move in the rightward direction with a speed 4 kilometers per hour. And the child appeared to move in the rightward direction as well with a speed 13 kilometers per hour. Now, essentially, as the time keeps on passing, the mother will continue moving towards the right direction because she has a velocity and the child will also move towards the right direction. So clearly the meeting point of the mother and child shall be somewhere here with respect to the ground. Now, once you establish that, initial separation between the child and the mother would be 50 meters because the child started from his father and ran all the way to his mother. And assuming the child ran a distance of d meters, I can say that the mom would have moved a distance of d minus 50 meters. Now, once we have established all this, I can simply write the equations as the first one for the parent, d minus 50 upon 1000 is equal to 4 into t. Now, d minus 50 is the distance covered. This value is in meters. So I divide that by 1000 to convert it in kilometers. Now this is equal to 4 kilometers per hour multiplied by t hours, the time taken by the child to reach to his mother. This 1000 is simply the conversion factor, bear in mind. Now if I write second equation for the motion of child, what I see is that d upon 1000, which is once again converting d meters to kilometers, is simply velocity of child, which is 13 kilometers per hour multiplied by t. So the child covers this much distance in the same time as the mom covers this much distance. So if I solve these two equations simultaneously, I obtain the value of t as 19.98 seconds. The time taken by the child when he is running in the direction of belt is 19.98 seconds. Now let's solve for the case when the child is running in the opposite direction of the belt. Now, in that situation, he'll be running from his mother to his father. Now, father has a velocity the same as the velocity of belt, which is 4 kilometers per hour in the right direction. And the velocity of child perceived by the ground observer, we saw, was 5 kilometers per hour in the left direction. So, clearly the meeting point will be somewhere in the middle, as you can see. Now, if I assume the distance covered by dad to be small d in this case, or small d meters in this case, the distance covered by child will simply be 50 minus d, because the original separation between them was 50. The child started from his mother and ran towards his father. This entire scene is observed by the ground observer, bear in mind. So, if I write the equation from the parent's point of view, I can say that d upon 1000 is simply is equal to 4 kilometers per hour into t hours, the time taken. Now, this 1000 is simply a conversion factor to convert from meter to kilometers. So, this equation says distance covered is speed into time. Similarly, if I write another equation for child, it will be 50 minus d upon 1000 is equal to 5 into t. 5 is the speed of child and t is the time taken. Once again, if I solve these two equations simultaneously, the value of t I obtain is once again 19.98 seconds. So, the time taken by the child when he is moving in the direction of belt and the opposite direction of belt is exactly equal to 19.98 seconds. Now, once you have established this, the last part of the question tells us what are the factors which will be observed differently if we stop being the ground observer and we observe the entire motion as parents who are standing on the belt. So, clearly, parents are at rest with respect to belt. So, the velocity of the child that they will perceive will simply be 9 kilometers per hour because everything will be moving with respect to the belt. Next, total time taken by the child to move between parents will not change. Why? Because this time, the time will be calculated by separation between the parents upon the velocity of child. The separation between the parents is 50 meters. So, converted to kilometers, it will be 50 upon 1000 divided by velocity of child is 9 kilometers per hour with respect to the belt. So, once you establish that, if I solve it, the time taken will come out to be 19.98 seconds. So, the time taken by the child will not change in any frame of reference, but the velocity of the child will be perceived differently in different frames. I hope this question is very, very clear to you. Thank you.